whole day.
Yonder come they.
Whole day.
Yonder come they.
Whole day.
Yonder come they. Dead and broke into my soul. Yonder come they.
It's judgment day.
Yonder come they.
It's judgment day.
Yonder come they.
It's judgment day.
Yonder come they. Dead and broke into my soul. Yonder come they.
Good afternoon. My name is Arthretta Holmes Martin, and I'm here to tell you some good news. It's about a group of people. They were bound by the love of two things, music and history. They came together and were then called the Washington Rebels Jubilee Voices. I'm part of them, that group of people, and I'm very proud to be. You see, we all came together in 2010. Our only role was supposed to be to help the Washington Rebels tell the story of the Civil War and how that war changed this nation. We have been on a fantastic journey ever since. We sing, we tell stories of African Americans, our ancestors. I tell you, along that way, we've been singing some of these songs, these things since we were children. Our family sang them, and now we singing them. In our communities, there are a lot of local families and tiny towns in the DC area, and many of these were founded by the descendants of the enslaved. They shared melodies and they heard on front porches and their grandmama's knee, and related family histories whispered through the ages from one generation to the other, inspiring tales of historical figures that were towering to us now. The Jubilee Voices continues the African tradition of oral storytelling and singing. We are giving our ancestors voice when we share these things, and we're passing their stories and traditions down to the next generation. Their testimonies strengthen and empower our lives. They remind us why the fight for freedom and equality must continue. We have to know that they mattered, and we have to know that we mattered. Their lives mattered. And now, let's get started learning a little bit about the Jubilee Voices. When we sing most of the time, we do this thing called call and response, audience participation. Tonight, this afternoon, we're gonna sing a song that I grew up on called Come By Here. Many of you may know it by Kumbaya. Well, it has the history in the Gullah Geechee people. Gullah Geechee people are throughout the south of the southeastern part of the United States. They come as north as Georgia and as far south as Florida. This song, Kumbaya, or really Kumbaya, or Kumbaya, depending on the version you know, I bet y'all know Kumbaya. It was first recorded in 1926 The Library of Congress right here in Washington, D.C. has a copy of it. And it was sung, and it's in its preservation of spirituals at the Library of Congress. Now, tonight I'm gonna first teach you this song, and then you're gonna repeat after me. How about that? Goes like this. Ready? Let's go. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Oh, Lord, kumbaya. Okay, that was just the practice part. Now, repeat after me. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Now your turn. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Good. Now the next verse. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. And you sing. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Then I'll sing. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Got it? Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. And then I finish. Oh, Lord, kumbaya. Now you finish. Oh, Lord, kumbaya. Okay. Now, let's sing this thing. One, two, ready, sing. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Kumbaya, my Lord, kumbaya. Hey, Lord, kumbaya. Oh, cinnamon needs your Lord, kumbaya. Cinnamon needs your Lord, kumbaya. Cinnamon needs your Lord, kumbaya. Oh, Lord, kumbaya. Somebody needs your Lord, kumbaya. Somebody needs your Lord, kumbaya. Somebody needs your Lord, kumbaya. Oh, Lord, kumbaya. Come by here. Come by here, my Lord. Come by here. Come by here, my Lord. Come by here. Come by here, my Lord. Come by here. Oh, Lord, come by here. One more time. Oh, Lord, come by here. Last time. Oh, Lord, come by here.
Thank you, Arthuretta, for leading us in that round of Kumbaya. So, as Arthuretta described what it is we do, clearly when we perform, we do a lot of time traveling. We sing in a lot of historic sites, and I would say that in so many places where we are performing, you can sometimes feel the spirit and the souls of all of those people who have been in that place before us. And I would say one place where we got a chance to perform, and it was just almost kind of a surreal experience. We were performing about 4 years ago at one of the most fascinating events. It was a reenactment of a slave wedding that took place at Arlington House. This is Robert E. Lee's house at Arlington Cemetery. And so in the early 1800s, two slaves of which the family was very fond of had their wedding in the parlor at the mansion. So in this reenactment, the people who were reenacting the bride and groom were actually descendants of that bride and groom. So we were there singing at this event and also singing after the event on the portico of Arlington House overlooking the city of Washington. There we are in our full costume, and it was this experience as, wow, how about this? Here we are singing on the steps of the home that was owned by descendants of George Washington and the military leader of the Confederacy singing songs of freedom for Black folks. It is a new day. So, but in terms of thinking about the past, this next song we're going to sing is I Know I've Been Changed, one of our most fond songs. And one of our late members sang it, June Lambert. And June was amazing, had the most compelling contralto voice. And it was a voice that when she sang, it made everybody just sit up and listen. Thanks to technology, we were able to recently do an updated version of that. And it's our whole group singing with June leading us. And this song we dedicate to her memory. Lord, I know I've been changed.
I know I've been changed. I know I've been changed. I know I've been changed. You know
the angels in heaven done sign my name.
Hi, my name is James Harkless. I sing baritone in the Jubilee Voices. I actually joined the Washington Rebels in 1986 and have been involved ever since, off and on. In 2010, when Andrea approached me and told me she was planning to start a group to sing spirituals, I was really very delighted. These songs have been a part of my entire life since I was a little boy. I consider them to be an essential part of my cultural heritage as a descendant of slaves. In fact, I felt they are so important that in 1976, when the Washington Performing Arts Society and the Friday Morning Music Club began their concerts in schools program, I auditioned and was accepted to sing and explain these songs for the school children in the district. I feel it's just so very important for me to preserve my and their heritage because these songs are the most important part of the African-American culture. I've also felt that just doing them individually doesn't give the best pictures. I felt that they should also be done as they were by the slaves, together in the fields, in their quarters at night. And Jubilee Voices has been the answer to this thought. By having field hollers and narratives, it gives the full context of how important these songs were for the enslaved people in helping them to endure the horrors and suffering of their captivity. They also express their hope for eventual freedom. And Jubilee Voices has been the answer to these dreams. In thinking about what we have accomplished and about this celebration, the thought occurred to me that actually, unconsciously, for the last 10 years, what Jubilee Voices has been doing for its audiences is proclaiming that Black Lives Matter. And I hope that they will continue to do so for many years.
What's going on, everybody? My name is David Fakwunle, part of the Jubilee Voices. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna take you to January 1st, 1863. That was the day the Emancipation Proclamation was enacted, saying that all enslaved Africans in southern states were now free. As you can imagine, slave owners weren't too privy to their property knowing that they were now free. So it took quite a while for the news to make it throughout the southern states. So now I'm gonna take you to Galveston, Texas, 2 years after the Emancipation Proclamation, where the enslaved Africans there were first informed of their freedom. Because of the importance of reading, you'd be lucky if there was one enslaved African who knew how to read, but everybody on the plantation knew who it was. So when this document started making its rounds that was saying we were now free, they took it to that enslaved African that they knew could read the document and make it known once and for all that they were truly free. So this song I'm about to lead you through is called Read 'em, John. It's in honor of Juneteenth. It is in honor of the official proclamation amongst the enslaved that they were free. As Mama Arthuretta said, this is call and response. So I will lead the call and you will respond in kind. So my call goes like this. I will say, read 'em, John, and you will respond, read 'em. I'll say it again. I'll say, read 'em, John. You'll respond, read 'em. I'll say it a third time, read 'em, John. And then you respond, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. All right, now we're gonna add a little melody to it. So I will sing, read 'em, John. And you'll respond, read 'em. Do it again. I'll say, read 'em, John. You'll respond, read 'em. Do it one more time. I'll say, read 'em, John. And then you'll respond, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. And then we'll repeat it a few times because this is good news. So we're going to keep reading it, repeating it, and repeating it, and repeating it until everybody gets it in their head. We are being let go. Okay? Now, here we go. Everybody ready? I'll do it one more time. Read 'em, John. Read 'em. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. All right, here we go. Get your voices ready. John brought the letter, laid it on the table. Tell all the members, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. With a 1x1 and a 2x2, 3x3 and a 4x4. Tell all the members, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. With a 1x1 and a 2x2, 3x3 and a 4x4. Tell all the members, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go. Read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John, read 'em, read 'em, John,
read 'em, oh, read 'em, let me go.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right. So we think about the past. That's a lot of what we do with Jubilee Voices. We acknowledge the past, we honor the past. We appreciate the journey that our ancestors have taken, and it has been a long and arduous journey. We think about all that they overcome, and so much of it was captured and immortalized in the songs. They were songs of freedom, songs of hope, songs of struggle, songs of pain, songs of resistance. And many of those lessons are lessons that were passed down through the generations. Even if we forgot the songs, we retained the lessons. After enslavement, through Jim Crow segregation, and we fast forward to 2020. We think about what is their future and now our present. So what do we do? What do we do with our present? What we do what our ancestors did? We fight. We resist and we sing. We think about all the dreams, all the hopes that they had for their children and their grandchildren and their great-grandchildren. And we as the Jubilee Voices, we as the descendants of the enslaved are now the realization of their dreams. But the journey still continues. There's still more that we have to do. There's still more that we must do. We must continue to speak our truth. We must continue to say and proclaim that Black lives truly do matter. We must lay the foundation for our future, our children, our grandchildren, to build upon everything that our ancestors have fought for, to build upon all the things that we continue to fight for. That is what Jubilee Voices is all about. In the African tradition, in the Ashanti, they say there's an Adinkra symbol, Sankofa. We reach back to move forward. There's no way that we can move forward without recognizing our past, without accepting and acknowledging our past, but everything that it has taught us. There is no other way. So we at the Jubilee Voices will continue to recognize our path because it gives us the tools, it gives us the strength, it gives us the stories and the music to move forward.
happening. Poor sinner stands a-trembling. A trumpet sounds within my soul.
Hello, everyone. My name is Andrea Blackford, and I'm the founder and director of Jubilee Voices. I want to tell you a little bit about the story behind the stories. To bring this wonderful music and information to you, we do a little bit of digging. It's sort of like an archaeological find, where we go to different sources, ranging from the Library of Congress, to local historical societies and libraries, to families themselves, to learn about the people who made the movement, even back before we knew there was a movement. We do research from sources like Slave Songs of the United States, the first compilation of African American spirituals and other music, written by were compiled by three abolitionists in 1867. We've gone digging in places that we never knew the stories were. We've walked through slave cemeteries, through old houses, even posters. I remember one from a Negro state fair. And we look at these things and yield so much information, and we pull them together and put them in our shows. One of the things that we love to do is spoken word, poetry that was taken from our ancestors that illustrates the life they lived and the things that they did and the culture that they passed down to us. So the next thing you're going to see is an example of that, just a sample, where we're going to take a poem from Paul Laurence Dunbar, the famous African-American poet, and combine it with a song that was sung to recruit African-American soldiers to Benedict, Maryland in 1863. One general, upon hearing the men sing this song, called it the Negro Battle Hymn.
Hark, listen to the trumpeters, they call for volunteers. On Zion's bright and flowery mount, behold the officers.
They was talking in the cabin, they was talking in the hall. I listen, kind of curious, not thinking about it all. On Sunday, too, I noticed they was whispering mighty much, standing there around the roadside when they let us out of church. I didn't think ill about it, till the middle of the week, when my lass come to see me. But somehow, he couldn't speak. Oh, then I seed in a minute what he come to see me for. They had listed colored soldiers, and my lass grown to war. Oh, I hugged him, I kissed him, I begged him not to go, but he told me that his conscience was calling him. He couldn't bear to linger when he had a chance to fight for the freedom they give and the glory of the right. So I hugged him and kissed him, and I promised to be true. And they put a knapsack on him and a coat all colored blue. So I gave him Pap's old Bible from the bottom of the drawer, when they listed colored soldiers and my lass going to war.
We look like men, we look like men, we look like men of war. All armed and dressed in uniform, we look like men of war.
We want no cowards in our band that will their colors fly. We call for valiant-hearted men who are not afraid to die.
We look like men, we look like men, we look like men of war. All armed and dressed in uniform, we look like men of war.
sets my heart quite in a flame, a soldier thus to be. I will enlist, gird on my arms, and fight for liberty. We look like men, we look like men, we look like men of war. All armed and dressed in uniform, we look like men of war.
Now it's time for a little more singing, I think. This is a song that we usually end our shows with. It is an amazing song that tells of the hope and the future of those who came before us. There's a line from a very famous poem by Maya Angelou, "And Still I Rise." We are the dreams and the hopes of our ancestors. We're the hope and dreams of the slave. And so we sing this song remembering the journey that our ancestors took with us, took for us, the blows that they took for us, the steps that they walked for us towards freedom so we could enjoy the liberties that we have today. And it gives us the strength to know that we're girding up and ready for the fight ahead to make sure that other people, the folks that come after us, enjoy freedom and equality as well. So, with no further ado, in that great getting up morning, there's a better day a coming, and I know you're gonna sing along too. Okay, so here we are, a virtual choir again, Washington Revels Jubilee Voices, in that great getting up morning.
There's a better day a coming.
Fare you well, fare you well.
There's a better day a coming.
Fare you well, fare you well.
When I see King Jesus.
Fare you well, fare you well.
When I see King Jesus.
Fare you well, fare you well.
Oh,
in that great getting up morning. Fare you well, fare you well. In that great getting up morning. Fare you well, fare you well. In that great getting up morning, fare you well, fare you well. In that great getting up morning, fare you well, fare you well.
There'll be no more crying.
Fare you well, fare you well.
There'll be no more crying.
Fare you well, fare you well.
There'll be no more dying.
Fare you well, fare you well.
There will be no more dying.
Fare you well.
Saints will be rising.
There'll
be no more striving.
There
will be no more striving.
Fare you well, into that great getting up morning. Fare you well, fare you well. In that great getting up morning. Fare you well, fare you well.
Oh,
in that great getting up morning. Fare you well.
Morning, fare you well.
So fare you well. That was in that great getting up morning, and we're singing it to you, even though it's the afternoon. We hope you sang along with us. And I think what this song and every song that we do demonstrate the theme of the Washington Rebels. It's about community, tradition, and music. And this music that we've sung is specific to the African-American tradition of music, but it is indeed part of the American fabric. So this is our last song. We're signing off here now, but you can find out what it is we're doing. Just go to our website, revelsdc.org. And do we have any questions, anyone? Andrea, are we taking questions right now?
Oh, yes, we are.
Okay. Anyone got questions? Put them in the chat.
Yes.
All right. I'm not seeing any questions, so
clear. Wait, I just see one. Let's see. How do we find the songs that we sing? Well, that depends. Sometimes we do research to find songs that were popular or proper for a certain period or time or event. More often than not, when we're asked to do a performance, we try to tailor our performances to the places where we're going. So we will go and do local history. We will go to like a historical society, and we will go to the historic site if there is one, and take pictures and ask people about that time in that community. And we also go to descendants, which is some of the most fun. We go to descendants and ask them what they sang and what their grandparents sang and their great grandparents and family songs. So there's a different mixture of what we do to figure out what songs we are singing. Another thing we like to do is if there is a popular song that has roots in a slave song or a spiritual or shout or holler, we will perform that song. And for example, for the Library of Congress, we did their homegrown archive challenge concert where we had to take some information from the Library of Congress and then field recordings, things like that, and then translate them into our own rendition of a song. And there's a song by Moby called, what is the name? But it takes an excerpt of a song by Vera Hall, a field recording where she sings Trouble So Hard. And this became an electronic music hit. And we took the original recording of Vera Hall. We heard it at the Folklife Center, in the American Folklife Center in the Library of Congress, and we learned it. And that's the majority of how we learn our songs. We listen to field recordings, and we try to put ourselves in the place of those folks and sing that song.
And I would say, too, that sometimes our music is very geographically specific. A few years ago, we were doing concerts for looking at the maritime tradition, the African-American maritime tradition of fishing on the Chesapeake. You know, I had no idea that African-Americans were even involved in that. So we've done a couple of concerts, and I will say that, you know, you get a bunch of men who are fishing alone on the Chesapeake. The songs are not G-rated, but at least if they're done originally, and David's laughing because David had sung the lead on a lot of those songs, but we can kind of smooth them
up.
It's
a lot about me. Yes, it does.
Yeah.
They're songs of love.
Well, I mean, lusty songs of love, I would say. But that's where the music comes from, and, you know, little threads like that. And someone has asked, is there a place where we perform regularly in Washington during non-COVID times? Not really. I mean, anyone who'll ask us to sing, you know, we'll sing for them. But I would just say keep an eye on our website, rebelsdc.org, and you can see what's going on.
Now, as things progress in this new normal, there will be things that we will be doing doing on a regular basis. We are hoping to do Juneteenth as a signature event for us. And there are other holidays and days of note in the African-American historic calendar and the American history calendar that we will be marking. So go to revelsdc.org for more details on that. Now, I see a question. Yes, we love that you transitioned to virtual for this, but given the air norm aspect of COVID, can you predict when you'll be able to sing in the presence of one each other and in public again?
How at this point, you can stand ahead of a pin.
Yeah.
Yeah. I did see something the other day that if you sing softly, you're less possible to transmit any of those air droplets, but I would say we can't predict when that's going to happen.
Our biggest thing is to keep everybody singing and safe. So that's why we have the Washington Revels Daily Antidote of Song that takes place at noon every day, where really great singers from around the area and around the world actually have shared songs with us, much in the way that we shared songs with you earlier today. We also want, like I said, everybody to be safe. So one of our big pushes is for everybody to learn this music that we sing and take it home. And this medium gives us a unique chance to showcase the music in a different way. So it's not the same as being together. It really isn't, but we're exploring new avenues of working with Zoom and social media and other ways to pass that music on and keep everybody fired up and singing. Because singing gets us through the hardest times, doesn't it?
All right, well, I think that's it, Andrea.
Wait, one thing, the Moby song, and I know this dates me, is called Natural Blues, just so you know. And that's where you can hear Vera Hall singing, "Oh Lord, Trouble So Hard." Also, if you go to the Library of Congress, there is a recording of that entire concert, which we shared with three or four other artists, where you can hear everything in its context, including Arthuretta singing Come By Here in Gullah and in English.
All right, everyone, we're going to sign off for now. It's wonderful singing for you this afternoon at this festival. So I would say keep on singing yourselves, keep on building community and tradition. Bye.
Bye.
Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. As we go marching on, oh, we're the bully soldiers of the first of Arkansas. We're fighting for the Union, we are fighting for the law. We can shoot a rebel father than a white man ever saw. As we go marching on, glory, 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 hallelujah. Yes, glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. As we go. See there above the center, where the flag is waving bright. We're going out of slavery, we are bound for freedom's light. We mean to show Jeff Davis
how the Africans can bite
as we